This video shows how to recover PowerCenter workflows and cloud data integration task flows. In PowerCenter, you can recover a suspended workflow and continue processing from the point of interruption. How this works? The PowerCenter integration service stores the state of operation in memory or on disk to determine where to begin recovery processing. In cloud data integration, you can restart a suspended task flow from the beginning, from the faulted step, or from the step after the faulted step. Let's get started. In a PowerCenter workflow, you can suspend a workflow when an error occurs, configure high availability, configure a recovery strategy for specific tasks in a workflow, and recover a workflow from the point of failure. Now let's go to the PowerCenter Workflow Manager and edit a workflow to enable recovery. When you enable recovery at the workflow level, PowerCenter suspends the workflow when an error occurs. You can also notify users when the workflow is suspended. If you have a high availability license and a node or service shuts down, workflows fail over to another node. You can automatically recover terminated tasks. You can also configure the number of recovery attempts that the PowerCenter integration service must make. Now we'll show you how to configure recovery for the tasks in the workflow. Just double-click a workflow to open the Workflow Designer. Then double-click a task icon and select the Properties tab. Depending on the task type, you can fail the task and continue the workflow, resume the task from the last checkpoint, or restart the task. When you recover a workflow, the PowerCenter integration service recovers the workflow tasks based on the task recovery strategy. When a workflow is suspended, right-click anywhere in the Workflow Designer and select Recover Workflow. The PowerCenter integration service recovers the workflow from the point of failure. PowerCenter will either fail, resume, or restart the task, and continue processing the workflow. Now we'll show you how to configure recovery in cloud data integration task flows. You can recover a cloud data integration task flow at the task flow level and at the step level. In cloud data integration, you open a task flow on the Explore page. To configure recovery at the task flow level, click the Advanced tab and then select the Suspend on Fault checkbox. When the task flow runs, if it encounters a fault, it gets suspended. To configure recovery for a task flow step, first click the step in the Design pane. Then, in the Step Properties, click the Error Handling tab. You can configure the step to suspend the task flow if the step encounters a warning or an error. To view a list of suspended task flows, go to the My Services page and select Monitor. On the All Jobs page, you can click here to restart the task flow from the beginning. To see additional restart options, click the task flow name. You can resume task flow processing from the step that encountered the warning or error, or skip the faulted step and resume task flow processing at the next step. And that's it! In this video, we showed you how to configure recovery for PowerCenter workflows and cloud data integration task flows. For more information, click the documentation links in the video description, visit our communities and support hubs, or check out our website.